Welcome to Savvy IT Solutions. Now we are discussing programming in Java. Important note, on 11th 4 2020, we are conducting live session on how a programmer can think. Okay, so we are also taking n number of examples on 11th at 8 a.m. So today we are discussing about scanner class. Using the scanner class, we will give the input to the program through keyboard. Till what we learn, we are learning the values given within the program. Or secondly, using command line arguments, we are taking input from the keyboard. Now it is similar to a scanner function in C language. So we are using scanner class and buffer reader class, two things in Java. So now we are discussing about scanner class. In the next video, we are learning about buffer reader class. So in the scanner class, we need to know about scanner class. We need to know about scanner class constructors and scanner class methods and scanner class examples. Scanner is a class in java.utility package used for obtaining the input of the primitive types like int, double, etc. and strings. It is the easiest way to read input in a Java program, though not very efficient if you want an input method for scenarios where time is a constraint like in competitive programming. To create an object of scanner class, we usually pass the predefined object system.in, which represents the standard input stream. We may pass an object of class file if we want to read input from a file. To read numerical values of a certain data type XYZ, the function to use is next XYZ. For example, to read a value of type short, we can use next short. To read strings, we use next line. To read a single character, we use next next or character at zero. Next function returns the next token word in the input as a string, and character at zero function returns the first character in that string. Okay, so moreover, this is the constructor where we are creating an object for scanner class. Firstly, we are importing a scanner class using import java.utility.star or utility.scanner. So after that, we are creating object for the scanner class, scanner SE. We can give any name here. So new scanner of system.in. So this system.in is nothing but provide the environment to read the data from keyboard. This SE is read the data from keyboard. So actually, I will take small example program to understand how the scanner class is working. So this is the way we are importing the scanner class. Next, we need to create an object for a scanner class. It also called construct scanner class object. Followed by, we need to define the variables, and we need to use the variables in such a way that we are giving input. So now, scanner class constructors. Scanner file source. It constructs a new scanner that produces values scanned from the specified file. Next one, scanner file source, string character set name. It constructs a new scanner that produces values scanned from the specified file. Scanner input stream source. It constructs a new scanner that produces values scanned from the specified input stream. Next one, scanner input stream source, string character set name. It constructs a new scanner that produces values scanned from the specified input stream. Scanner readable source. It constructs a new scanner that produces values scanned from the specified source. Scanner string source. It constructs a new scanner that produces values scanned from the specified string. Scanner readable byte channel source. It constructs a new scanner that produces values scanned from the specified channel. Scanner readable by readable byte channel source string character set name. It constructs a new scanner that produces values scanned from the specified channel. Scanner path source. It constructs a new scanner that produces values scanned from the specified file. Scanner path source comma string character set name. It constructs a new scanner that produces values scanned from the specified file. So now we need to discuss what are the methods available in scanner class. First one is the close. It is used to close the scanner. Delimiter. It is used to get the pattern which the scanner class is currently using the match delimiters. Find all. It is used to find a stream of match results that match the provided pattern string. Find inline. It is used to find the next occurrence of a pattern constructed from the specified string, ignoring delimiters. Find within origin. It is used to find the next occurrence of a pattern constructed from the specified string, ignoring delimiters. As next, it returns true if this scanner has another token in its input. As next big decimal. It is used to check if the next token in this scanner's input can be interpreted as a big decimal using the next big decimal method or not. As next big integer, it is used to check if the next token in this scanner's input can be interpreted as a big decimal using the next big decimal method or not. As next boolean, it is used to check if the next token in this scanner's input can be interpreted as a boolean using the next boolean method or not. As next byte, it is used to check if the next token in this scanner's input can be interpreted as a byte using the next big decimal method or not. So as next double, it is used to check if the next token in this scanner's input can be interpreted as a big decimal using the next byte method or not. As next float, as next int, as next line, as next long, as next short, almost all same meaning. IO exception. It is used to get the IO exception last thrown by this scanner's readable. Locale. It is used to get a locale of the scanner class. Match. It is used to get the match result of the last scanning operation performed by the scanner. Next, it is used to get the next complete token from the scanner which is in use. Next big decimal. It scans the next token of the input as a big decimal. Next big integer. It scans the next token of the input as a big integer. Next boolean. It scans the next token of the input into a boolean value and returns that value. Next byte. It scans the next token of the input as a byte. Next double. It scans the next token of the input as a double. Next float. It scans the next token of the input as a float. Next int. It scans the next token of the input as an int. Next line. It is used to get the input string that was skipped of the scanner object. Next long. It scans the next token of the input as a long. Next short. It scans the next token of the input as a short. Radix. It is used to get the default radix of the scanner user. Remove. It is used when remove operation is not supported by this implementation of iterator. Reset. It is used to reset the scanner which is in use. Skip. It skips input that matches the specified pattern, ignoring delimiters. Tokens. It is used to get a stream of delimiter separated tokens from the scanner object which is in use. ToString. It is used to get the string representation of scanner string using. Use delimiter. It is used to set the delimiting pattern of the scanner which is in the use of specified pattern. Use locally. It is used to sets the scanner local object to the specified locally. Use radix. It is used to set the default radix of the scanner which is in use to the specified radix. So taking small example, we need to read a string. So first we are importing it, next one is object for object creation, next line is the it reads, it scans the string, so it is assigned to name and we need to print the value of the name. Finally we need to close that in that close. Similarly, now I am taking a little bit more. So here we are importing it, next one is creating object. First one is we need to read the boolean result as next. Next read string, next line. Next read, again we need to create one more object. I am closing it and read name, so string. Again read age means integer and salary means double. We are reading three different objects, different types of data input is taken into account.